Dear students, welcome to online class on digital image processing. In this video, we are going to discuss the fundamental steps involved in digital image processing. Basically, there are 10 fundamental steps in digital image processing. Rather calling them as fundamental steps, I would like to call them as different branches of digital image processing or different areas in digital image processing. Because when we consider any image processing task, we may not need all the 10 basic steps. Then how many steps are required for an image processing task? It depends on our objectives and outcomes of the image processing task. But our task may require at least few steps among these 10 basic steps. We have already said that an image is worth more than 1,000 words because it is easy to understand from the images. So, without much boring explanation, let us now represent these fundamental steps of digital image processing in a block diagram form. You may now pause the video and note down this block diagram. So, the fundamental steps in digital image processing are image acquisition, image enhancement, image restoration, color image processing, wavelets and multi-resolution processing, image compression, morphological processing, segmentation, representation and description, and object recognition. We can observe that the outputs of steps from image acquisition to morphological processing are generally images. Recall that in low-level image processing, both inputs and outputs are images. Hence, these steps come under low-level image processing. On the other hand, the outputs of steps from morphological processing to object recognition are generally attributes. Therefore, these steps belong to mid-level image processing. You may note that morphological image processing is between low-level image processing and the mid-level image processing. That is, it can be either classified into low-level image processing or mid-level image processing, depending on the complexities of the processing task. Now let us consider these steps one by one. So to begin with, image acquisition. In simple words, image acquisition is nothing but capturing the photos. This step is governed by the problem domain. The nature of the object under imaging and the nature of the images define the problem domain. For example, to capture the X-ray images of the bone, we need X-ray machine. To capture images of bacteria or virus, we need microscopic cameras. In case of remote surveillance, we may need IR cameras. To capture aerial views, we need panoramic cameras, etc. So these are the different problem domains. Okay, the image acquisition refers to the process of capturing real-world images and storing them in the digital form. The sources of images may be video cameras, fish eye camera, omni camera, infrared camera, radar, X-ray imaging, CT that is computational tomography, range cameras that is laser camera, etc. A fish eye camera is a wide angle lens that produces visual direction intended to create a wide panoramic or hemispherical image. Omni cameras are cameras with a 360 degree field of view. Most of the times, the image acquisition stage involves pre-processing such as scaling. That is, the size of the acquired images are either greater than the objects or lesser than the objects. In a rare case, there will be no scaling That is, the size of the image is exactly equal to the size of the object. Okay, now let us consider image enhancement. The objective of image enhancement is to improve the interpretability of information present in the images. Hence, the image enhancement algorithms emphasize, sharpen, or smooth image features for display and analysis. Examples for image enhancement are contrast enhancement, brightness enhancement, histogram equalization, etc. Next is image restoration. Image restoration is a special kind of image enhancement where the mathematical model for source degradation is known. Here in the first image, you can see some artifacts. If these artifacts are mathematically modeled, then we can restore the actual image. Color image processing is an important area in digital image processing because color is the most visually striking feature of any image. Color image processing has been gaining more importance because color images are widely used in internets, medical and industrial sectors. Okay, the next step is wavelets and multi-resolution processing. Wavelets are the foundation for representing images in various degrees of resolution. Hence, it is used in image compression and recognition. Here in the slide, you can see the LENA image is decomposed into four parts using some wavelet transform. LL represents low frequency component of the image, HH represents high frequency component of the image, and LH and HL represent intermediate frequency component of the image. The high frequency component contain more subtle details and they do not contribute much for human observer. Hence, these components can be discarded, but it results in a low quality image. For example, when we share images and videos through communication media such as WhatsApp, similar technique is used. Here, the images and videos can be shared quickly due to the reduced size by sacrificing the quality. Another fundamental step in image processing is image compression. Image compression is minimizing the size in bytes of a graphic file without degrading the quality, that is lossless compression, or with acceptable degradation, that is lossy compression. Image compression saves disk space for storage and time for transmission. Morphological processing. The morphological processing deals with developing tools for extracting forms and structures of image regions. The image components generally used for describing the region shapes are boundaries and skeletons. The process involves erosion, dilation, opening and closing. Next is segmentation. Segmentation is concerned with dividing an image into meaningful regions. Hence, it is the process of partitioning an image into groups of pixels which are homogeneous with respect to some criteria. It is said that the success of recognition depends upon the accuracy of segmentation. Representation and description. It almost always follows the output of segmentation. The output of segmentation is either boundary of a region or the complete region. In either case, this raw data is represented in the form suitable for computer processing. Description or feature selection deals with extracting attributes for the classification of objects. Recognition. It is the process that assigns a label, for example, notebook, to an object based on its descriptors. The knowledge base. Knowledge base guides the operation of each processing module and also controls the interaction between the modules. In this subject, we are going to discuss these fundamental steps in detail in different modules as mentioned here. Image acquisition in module number 1, image enhancement in module 2, image restoration in module 3, color image processing, wavelet and multi-resolution processing in module 4, also morphological processing in module 4, segmentation, representation and description in module 5. So in this video, we have discussed 10 different fundamental steps involved in digital image processing. Thank you and have a nice time.